ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुषुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स पदांतिकं। वंदेहं श्री गुर श्रीयुत पदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं कृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादं सहगना ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे वंचाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरतिष्ये नमः। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंध जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्ते। तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। मुखम करति वाचलम पुंगुल्लंघायते गिरिं यत्कृपादमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुदिनतारिणं परमानंदमाधवं श्रीचैतन्येश्वरम्। So request everyone, if you have proper internet and if there is no other reason, then you can put on your video so that we can be more personal and we can interact also, if you don't mind with that. So we'll continue our discussion on delivering Putana. So yesterday we stopped our discussion where Putana kept Krishna on her lap and she wanted to kill Krishna by feeding the breast milk. And Putana smeared her breast with halahala poison, very dangerous poison. And what happens now, we'll discuss. So we'll try to complete the pastime today and from tomorrow we'll discuss about Kaliya. So Sukadeva Goswami is continuing his discussion. So the incident is happening in the house of Nanda Maharaj in Gokul. So Putana came in disguise. She came in a very beautiful form, very beautiful form, very beautiful lady, like a celestial lady. Although originally she is very ugly looking as an witch or demoness, but because of her mystic power, she transformed into a very beautiful lady. And Rohini and Jashoda Maiya, they did not stop her because she was also showing motherly affection. She was very beautiful. She was very charming. And it was a desire of Krishna also that she should not be stopped, because this pastime of Krishna is arranged by the Jogamaya potency of the Supreme Lord. So that's why, although Putana was there in the house of Nanda Maharaj to kill Krishna, but nobody stopped her. And this was because of the arrangement of Krishna through Yogamaya portals. So now what's happening? On that very spot, the fiercely dangerous Rakshasi took Krishna on her lap and pushed her breast into his mouth. The nipple of her breast was smeared with a dangerous, immediately effective poison. But the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, becoming very angry at her, took hold of her breast and squeezed it very hard with both hands and sucked out both the poison and her life. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This pastime happened when Krishna was only 7 days old. So Putana, her size was 12 miles. That will be discussed later. Very dangerous, very powerful, witch, demoness. But Krishna, without any effort, effortlessly, without the help of any weapon, killed her. That's why Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna doesn't have to become powerful by some mystic yoga process. He doesn't have to get the power because he's the source of all power, because he's the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Vaisarjasya samagrasya virjasya jasa hasriya jnana vairagasya eva sangnang bhaga itingana. Parashar Muni, the father of Vyasadeva, has defined God. Who can be God? Who has 6 opulences? Wealth, power, fame, beauty, knowledge, and renunciation. So Krishna is extremely powerful. He is a source of all power. Actually, everything comes from him. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam prabuddhate iti matta bhajante mam buddha bhava samannita. Bhagavad Gita also explains that the Krishna is the source of everything. And that's why he is a source of all power also. So we cannot become God. Krishna is always God. We are always the servant of God. We are always part and parcel of God. There is a misconception that we can become God by some yoga process. That is not the reality. We cannot become God because God is always God. When he was 7 days old, he killed Putana without any effort. Effortlessly he killed her. That's why he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Krishna sucked the milk, Krishna sucked the poison, and Krishna also sucked the life air of Putana and effortlessly killed her. And what is happening with Putana? Unbearably pressed in every vital point, the demon Putana began to cry, "Please leave me, suck my breast no longer. Perspiring, her eyes wide open, and her arms and legs flailing, she cried very loudly again and again. So Putana, although she was very powerful, so by the pressing of Krishna, Krishna just pressed the breast of Putana and sucked the breast, and by that Putana left her body. So powerful Krishna is. Very, very powerful. And when she was killed, what happened? As Putana screamed loudly and forcefully, the earth with its mountains, the outer space with its planets trembled. By that we can understand the power of Putana also. She was so powerful, her sound made the earth with its mountains to tremble, the outer space also to tremble. lower planets in all directions vibrated and people fell down unconscious, fearing that thunderbolts were falling upon them. That was the power of Putana. That was the power of the sound of Putana. The sound is very powerful. So when we are in deep sleep, the sound wakes us up. The alarm clock wakes us up. The sound is very, very powerful. So here, the sound of Putana trembled the whole universe. That was the power of Putana's sound. So by that we can understand, if we can hear the transcendental sound, what will be the effect in our life? That's why Krishna has appeared in transcendental sound vibration in this age of Kali, in the form of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So in this age of Kali, Krishna has appeared in the form of holy name. So when we hear this sound, Krishna and Krishna's name, the sound vibration is identical. There is no difference. That is also explained in the Shastra. We should have faith in that holy name. Nam Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Purna Suddha Nitya Mukta Abhinnatak Nama Nami. So Krishna and Krishna's name is, they are identical. There is no difference. Both are transcendental. And when we hear that transcendental sound vibration, there is changes in our heart. So therefore, sound is very, very important. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhaka Gunai Sravanadi Siddha Chitta Karo Uday. It is explained that the love of Krishna, love of Godhead is there in our heart. But when you hear that sound vibration, then what happens? That love of Godhead is awakened in our heart. So therefore, sound is very, very important. So you should be very, very careful what kind of sound we hear and what kind of sound we vibrate from our tongue. Because tongue is very, very powerful because it vibrates the sound. So Prabhupada says that if we talk about Krishna, then what will happen? The tongue will be treated as a chest person. But when the tongue is not vibrating Krishna's name, Krishna's fame, Krishna's glories, that tongue will be as unchaste. Because we are the servant of Krishna, so our duty is to chant the name of Krishna. That is our dharma, that is our duty. So therefore, sound plays a very important role in our life. So here, the sound of Putana, while she was dying, that created a havoc in the whole universe. So in this way, demon Putana very much aggrieved because her breast was being attacked by Krishna. Lost her life. O King Parikshit, opening her mouth wide and spreading her arms, legs and hair, she fell down in the pasturing ground in her original form as a Rakshasi, as Bhitrasura had fallen when killed by the thunderbolt of Indra. So here, Putana's body, Putana, has been compared with Bhitrasura. Those who are familiar with Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a demon, big-sized demon, Bhitrasura, was killed by Indra by his thunderbolt. So here, Krishna's killing, Putana, is compared with that killing of Bhitrasura by Indra. Because Bhitrasura, his size was also very big. Putana's size also was very big. And what was the size of Putana's body? O King Parikshit, when the gigantic body of Putana fell to the ground, it smashed all the trees within a limit of 12 miles. So Putana's body was 12 miles. Huge. But people think, oh, it's all story. It's all imagination. This is not story, this is history. This is all absolutely true. And when you have faith in the words of the Shastra, when you have faith in the words of the Acharyas, then we can understand Krishna. We can understand the Lord. So therefore, faith is very, very important. Faith is scientific, it's not emotional thing. At every step in our life, we need to have faith. Prabhupada gives the example that if you want to know who is your father, then mother says that he is your father. Then we accept it. That is the process. But some may argue, no, I don't accept the words of the mother. Then what do you have to do? We have to experiment the DNA of all the fathers of the world. And it's very impractical, impossible to know who is our father. So our journey of our life begins with the faith in the words of the mother. So Krishna is our supreme father. And Veda is our supreme mother. So Veda says, Krishna is the supreme personality of God. Therefore, we have to accept it. But it is not a blind faith. It can be experimented. It can be realized through our experience. So therefore, journey should begin with the faith. So here, Putana's body is described as 12 miles long. Huge body. And by this you can understand, appearing in a gigantic body, she was certainly extraordinary. And her body is explained, because she was so huge, her body is also explained in detail. By that you can understand that this is not a story, this is not an imagination. This is the fact. The Rakshasi's mouth was full of teeth, each resembling the front of a plow. Her nostrils were deep like mountain caves. Her breast resembled big slabs of stone fallen from a hill. Her scattered hair was the color of copper. The sockets of her eyes appeared like deep blind wells. Her fearful thighs resembled the banks of a river. Her arms, legs, and feet seemed like big bridges. Her abdomen appeared like a dried up lake. The herds, the ears, and the heads of the cowherd men and women were already shocked by the Rakshasi's screaming. And when they saw the fierce wonder of her body, they were even more frightened. The sound of dying Putana created a havoc. People become very scared. They thought that thunderbolt fell on their body. That was the level of the sound of Putana. The whole universe trembled. So now, by seeing the body of Putana, the inhabitants of Vrindavan, they became more frightened. Because such a huge, gigantic, ferocious, ugly-looking body of Putana created a fear and created a wonder into the minds of all the inhabitants of Vrindavan. But what is happening with Krishna? The whole universe trembled. People become scared. People become wonderstruck. But what is happening with Krishna, 7-year-old boy? What he is doing? Without fear, the child Krishna was playing on the upper portion of Putana Rakshasi's breast. And when the gopis saw the child's wonderful activities, they immediately came forward with great jubilation and picked him up. So Krishna effortlessly killed such a gigantic demon. And he was happily playing on her body. By this we can understand the position of Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. We cannot imitate this kind of activity. These are all superhuman activity. These are the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. These are not story. These are the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, which is also known as Leela. Krishna's activities are Leela because these are eternal by nature. Our activities are temporary, but Krishna's activities are eternal. Krishna's activities are transcendental. Krishna's activities are beyond our thinking. That's why Krishna is known as Achintya. We cannot think. It is beyond our thinking. That's why it is said, who can understand Krishna? Who has implicit faith in the inconceivable potency of the Supreme Personality of God? If we don't have faith in that inconceivable potency, we cannot understand Krishna. Because Krishna is infinite. Krishna is super powerful. So there's a story by which you can understand how it is very difficult to understand Krishna. So Narad Muni once was coming from Vaikuntha planet and he met a Brahmana. Brahmana was very learned and he knew all the shastras, he knew all the slokas, he had all kinds of knowledge. So when he saw Narad Muni, he knew it was Narad Muni. Narad Muni is a great sage, he knows Krishna, he moves around different parts of the universe, he goes to the spiritual world also. So he knew everything. So when he saw Narad Muni, so he asked Narad Muni, where did you come from? So Narad Muni said, I am coming from Vaikuntha planet. Oh, so you are coming from Vaikuntha planet. He also knows that Vaikuntha planet is the abode of the Supreme Lord. He said, oh, you are coming from Vaikuntha planet, then what did my Supreme Lord was doing? Then Narad Muni said that your Lord was doing something wonderful. What he was doing? So he took a needle in one hand and he took an elephant, big elephant in other hand. And he was passing through that elephant through the hole or eye of the needle. So when that Brahmana heard that elephant was passing through the hole of the needle, he started laughing. He said, how it is possible? You're talking something very impractical thing. And he said that this is not possible. Narad Muni understood that this Brahmana does not have any faith, whatever he has said. So he left that place. From our point of view also is very impractical. How an elephant can go through the hole of the needle? The hole of the needle is very small and elephant is very, very big in size. How is this possible that elephant will go through that the hole of the needle? Then he met a cobbler. Narad Muni met a cobbler. Cobbler was not so learned, but he was a pure devotee of the Lord. He was very pure. So when he saw Narad Muni, he welcomed Narad Muni and asked Narad Muni that where from you are coming. He told the same thing, I am coming from a Vaikuntha planet. Then he asked the same question, what my Lord was doing in Vaikuntha planet. So Narad Muni replied the same thing, that he was passing through that elephant through the eye of the needle. As soon as the cobbler heard that, he was so amazed and he started crying, oh, my dear Lord is doing such a wonderful act. And Narad Muni said, do you have faith what I said? How is this possible? How an elephant can go through the hole of a needle? Then cobbler said, from our point of view, it is very impossible. But for my Lord, it's nothing. So Narad Muni said, how? How it is possible? Then that cobbler gave an example. He was sitting under a banyan tree. And he saw that in that banyan tree, there's a fruit. So in that fruit, there is a small seed. So in that seed, how many banyan trees are there? He started asking questions to Narada Muni. So in that seed of that banyan tree, there is unlimited number of banyan trees. Because from one seed, there will be another banyan tree. In that banyan tree, there will be so many banyan tree, banyan fruits and seeds. In that way, Krishna can expand. That is Krishna's creation. We manufacture so many things, automobiles. But one automobile cannot create another automobile. Prabhupada used to say that Krishna has created one male body and another female body. And they unite together and they can create another human body. That is Krishna's creation. But our creation cannot have that because we are not the Supreme Lord. So that cobbler said that if my Lord can keep unlimited number of banyan tree inside a small seed, so for him passing through an elephant through the eye of the needle, what is a big deal? That is the inconceivable potential of the Supreme Personality of God. So when we have faith in the inconceivable potential of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then we can understand Him. Sei sei Ishwar tatva bujibare pare Ishwarer kripale hoyeche jahar. It is explained in this Bengali verse that if someone has faith in the inconceivable potential of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then he receives the mercy. Only by the causeless mercy of the Supreme Lord, we can understand Him. By our own effort only, we cannot understand Krishna. That's why Rupa Goswami says in Nectar of Devotion that Shuddha Bhakti or pure devotional service is Sudurlava, is almost impossible to get. Sulava means easily available. Durlava means very rarely available. And Sudurlava means very, very rare, almost impossible to get it. Why? Rupa Goswami gives two reasons. First reason is that pure devotional service cannot be obtained by our own endeavor, and Krishna also doesn't want to give it. So then how to get it? So you can get pure bhakti only by the mercy of the pure devotees. When pure devotees are pleased, then we can get pure bhakti. Because pure devotees are the owner of pure So, Shuddha Bhakta, our pure devotees, can give us pure devotional service. That is the process. That is the arrangement made by Krishna. So, therefore, we have to have faith in the inconceivable potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The logic, reasoning can go to a certain limit. After that, logic and reasoning doesn't work to understand the absolute nature of the Supreme Lord. That's why He is transcendental. He is beyond material nature. He is beyond three modes. Our intelligence is up to the three modes. That's why Krishna also says in Bhagavad Gita, Traigunna Vishaya Veda Nistraigunna Bhavarjuna. Krishna told Arjuna that the Vedas deal with the three modes. But if you want to know me, then you have to transcend the three modes. Because Krishna is also beyond three modes. So in order to know Krishna, we have to go beyond the three modes. If we are influenced by the three modes of material nature, we cannot understand Krishna. Because Krishna is beyond three modes. That's why Traigunna Vishaya Veda Nistraigunna Bhavarjuna. So Krishna recommends to know Him, we have to transcend the three modes. And how we can transcend the three modes? By engaging in pure devotional service under the guidance of a bona fide spiritual master. And the best process of devotional service is to hear the message of Godhead from a bona fide source. So here, Krishna, although He is 7 days old and He killed such a dangerous demon and he killed effortlessly, without any effort, without taking any support of anyone, without taking any weapon. He just sucked the breast, and he sucked the breast milk, poison, and also the life air of Putana, and Putana was killed. And after killing, he was not affected. He was just playing on the upper portion of the chest of Putana. And the gopis felt very happy by seeing Krishna playing on the body of Putana. And what did they do? The gopis saw the child's wonderful activities. They immediately came forward with great jubilation and picked him up. Then what is the reaction of the mothers? Because Vrindavan is full of Krishna bhakti. They love Krishna without any conditioning. They don't love Krishna because Krishna is God. They love Krishna because Krishna is very wonderful. Krishna is very beautiful. Krishna is very sweet. That is a relationship, family relationship. So, what was happening to Mother Yashoda and Rohini? Thereafter, Mother Yashoda and Rohini, along with the other elderly gopis, wept about the switch of a cow to give full protection to the child, Sri Krishna. So, we know that Krishna is the protector. But here, the mothers of Krishna, the Rohini and Yashoda, are in anxiety to protect Krishna. And how they are protecting? They are using the tail of the cow, that switch of the cow, and that is very, very auspicious. That gives protection. That is a symptom of a culture, that is a system of a religious minded person. When they are in difficulty, when their children are in difficulty, they take shelter of cows. Because cow is very, very powerful. Cow is very, very auspicious. So first, what did they do? They wept about the switch of a cow to give full protection to the child, Sri Krishna. Then, what they are doing? The child was thoroughly washed with the cow urine, and then smeared with the dust raised by the movements of the cows. Then different names of the Lord were applied with countdown on 12 different parts of his body, beginning with the forehead, as done in applying tilaka. In this way, the child was given protection. Actually, we can be only protected by the Supreme Lord. Krishna can only protect us. That is the real knowledge. But we go for protection to so many other people. They can give some protection, but ultimately, they cannot give protection. So ultimate protector is the Supreme Lord. And the devotees, they know that. That's why when they are in difficulty, they take shelter of the Supreme Lord. So here, Mother Yashoda, Mother Rohini, and all the gopis, elderly gopis of Vrindavan, they are taking help of the cows, and they are taking help of the name of Krishna. They are putting the mark on the 12 parts of the body of Krishna. That is the way a Vaishnava puts tilaka on the 12th section of our body, because our body is like a temple. Temple means where the Lord resides. So all of us know that the Paramatma resides in the heart of every living entity. So in our body, in the region of the heart, the Supreme Personality of Godhead in the form of Paramatma resides. So wherever the Lord resides, that becomes a temple. So in our body, the Lord is residing. So therefore, our body is a temple. And temple has to be decorated. And temple has to be marked with the name of Krishna. That's why when we put the tilaka on our 12 parts of our body, we chant the name, different names of Krishna to mark that tilaka. And by that, we establish Krishna in different parts of our body. In that way, we are protected by Krishna, by his names. So Krishna's name is very, very powerful, and it can give us protection. So therefore, the devotees, when they are in difficulty, whether they are in difficulty or not difficulty, they always take shelter of Krishna by chanting his holy name. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे. And Krishna's body was also washed by cow urine. Whatever comes out from the cow is very auspicious and very pure. Generally, urine is not pure; it's very impure. Generally, the stool is not so is not pure; it is really impure. Generally, when we touch the stool of other person, generally we take bath to purify ourselves. But here, the cow's stool, which is known as cow dung, that and also the cow urine are used to purify Krishna's body, to purify those who are having the Vedic culture. They use the cow urine and cow dung to purify themselves. That is a Vedic culture, because cow urine, cow dung is very, very pure. So in any religious activity, any spiritual activity, the people, those who have that knowledge and those who have that culture, they use cow dung and cow urine for the performance of any auspicious activity. So here, the Brajavasis, the elderly gopis, they are also doing that. So then they started chanting mantras. They did achaman, purified themselves, and the elderly gopis started chanting mantras. They started chanting the names, different names of the Lord for the protection of Krishna and in his different situations, so for the protection of the different limbs of his body. In that way, they perform their services to protect Krishna. Then Sukadeva Goswami is continuing. So Sukadeva Goswami continued, all the gopis headed by Mother Jasoda were bound by material affection. After they thus chanted mantras to protect the child, Mother Jasoda gave the child the nipple of her breast to suck and then got him to lie down on his bed. So this is the section where we can see how the motherly affection is there in Vrindavan. If you want to know what is motherly affection, then we have to hear the motherly affection of Mother Jasoda, motherly affection of Rohini, because they are the original mothers. They are the mothers of the Supreme Lord. If we want to know what is motherly affection, they are the gurus. So, parental affection, the embodiment of parental affection is Mother Jasoda. So, therefore, Mother Jasoda is acting like a perfect mother, because she is the mother of the absolute Supreme Personality of Godhead. And what's happening with Nanda Maharaj? Because we heard that Nanda Maharaj went to Mathura to pay taxes. And Vasudev told him that there will be some disturbances in Gokul, go quickly. How it was possible? Because Vasudev knew the plan of Kamsa of killing all the babies. And Vasudev gave that information to Nanda Maharaj. So meanwhile, all the cowherd men headed by Nanda Maharaj returned from Mathura, and when they saw on the way the gigantic body of Putana lying dead, they were struck with great wonder. Nanda Maharaj and other gopas exclaimed, "My dear friends, you must know that Anagadundavi Vasudev has become a great saint or a master of mystic power. Otherwise, how could he have foreseen this calamity and predicted it to us?" So Vasudev was an expert minister, expert king, and he knew what's going on in Mathura, because he used to get information from Akrura. All the plans of Kamsa was known to Vasudev, and in that way he could also explain to Nanda Maharaj what's going to happen in Gokul. So then what's happening with the body of Putana? Rasputana was killed, her body was very big. So, body has to go through the final rites. That is the culture. Even if she was the Rakshasi, even if she was the witch, even if she was the demoness, the inhabitants of Braj, they did a funeral rites of Putana. The inhabitants of Braj cut the gigantic body of Putana into pieces with the help of axes. Then they threw the pieces far away, covered them with wood and burned them to ashes. Now it's a very interesting statement given by Sukadeva Goswami. Because of Krishna's having sucked the breast of the Rakshasi Putana, when Krishna killed her, she was immediately freed of all material contamination. Her sinful reactions automatically vanished, and therefore when her gigantic body was being burned, the smoke emanating from her body was fragrant like Oguru incense. Generally, when dead body is burned, bad smell comes. That is the normal thing. But here, Putana was a Rakshasi. She was a demon. She was a witch. Ugly body, ugly consciousness, ugly habits, ugly intentions. But what's happening with her body? When her body was burned, the body was, the smoke emanating from her body was fragrant like Oguru incense. It was very fragrant. Very nice fragrance was coming. How is it possible? It is possible because Putana was touched by Krishna. Krishna is supremely pure. Just like fire. If you put everything in fire, then it burns everything. A place which is very filthy, if there is sun ray, if there is sun rays fall on that place, it becomes pure. All impurities go away. That is the power. So Krishna is very, very powerful. So when a sinful person gets connected with that Supreme Personality of Godhead, his sinful life, his sinful propensities are destroyed. That is the beauty of Krishna consciousness. That's why Srila Prabhupada said, if you want to be free from sinful reactions, if you want to be free from karmic reaction, if you want to be free from impurities, then get in touch with the Supreme Lord through devotional service. So when we engage our senses, when we engage our mind, when we engage our words, then our words, our mind, our senses are purified because Krishna is very pure. And that is the meaning of bhakti. Sarvopadi vinir muktam tatparatana nirmalam rishikena rishikesha sevanam bhakti ruchat. What is the meaning of bhakti? Engaging our senses in the service of the Lord. Very simple. Through our eyes, we see things. We should see the beautiful form of Krishna. We should see the beautiful form of the devotees. We should see the beautiful abode of the Supreme Lord. In that way, our eyes can be engaged in the service of the Lord. In the same way, our ears can be engaged in the service of the Lord by hearing about Krishna. Our tongue can be engaged in the service of the Lord by talking about Krishna, by tasting Krishna Prasad. Our skin can be used in the service of Krishna by touching the devotees. Our nose can be also used by taking the fragrance of the incense, by taking the fragrance of the flowers offered to the Supreme Lord. So in that way, all our senses can be engaged. And when our senses are engaged, then our senses will be purified. That is the process of purification. So here, Putana, although he did not come for purifying herself, But somehow or other, he got in touch with Krishna. Krishna did not only touch, he also sucked the breast milk from Putana. Because of the touch of Krishna, Putana became completely pure. And all the reactions, all the sinful reactions of our life and previous lives were completely finished. And she was pure. Not only her soul became purified, her body, material body was also purified. And that's why that body, purified body, was emanating the fragrance of our Guru. That is the power of Krishna consciousness. Therefore, it is recommended, somehow or other, we have to be connected with the Supreme Lord. And very easy way, very simple way to connect with Krishna is to chant His holy name. Very easy way to connect with Krishna is to hear about Krishna. It's very easy way to connect with Krishna by being connected with the representative of Krishna, which is known as Sadhu Sangha. So Sadhu Sangha is the birthplace of bhakti. Sadhu Sangha is the place of purification. So therefore, we become fortunate in our life when we get in touch with the sadhus. So that is very, very important lesson to be learned. Here, Putana became purified because she was in touch with Krishna. Although she did not have pure intention, but Krishna is very pure. So whether she had pure intention or not, she became purified. That is the potency of Krishna. So Putana was always hankering for the blood of human children. Because her food was the blood of the children. And with that desire, she came to kill Krishna. But because she offered her breast to the Lord, she attained the greatest achievement. What then is to be said of those who had natural devotion and affection for Krishna as mothers and who offered him their breast to suck or offered something very dear as a mother offers something to a child? So Putana did not come to offer breast milk to her. She came to kill Krishna, but Krishna accepted the motherly part. That is the quality of Krishna. That is his quality. Krishna always sees the good thing. That's why a swan, Hansa, if there is a mixture of milk and water, a swan takes the milk. He knows how to take the good thing. That is the nature of the Supreme Lord also. If we have so many bad qualities, and if we have only one good quality, Krishna will pick up that good quality and engage that good quality in the service. But we, the people of this world, we have a tendency to see only the bad qualities, and we don't want to see the good qualities in others. Why? Because our heart is full of envy. And because of that, we are not happy what we have. Rather, we are unhappy what we do not have. Because of envy, we compare and become unhappy. So comparison is the cancer of the mind. We know the cancer of the body, but Shastra explains the cancer of the mind. Because mind is very, very important. So compare, then complain, then criticize. These are the three cancers of the mind. And because of the three cancers, we cannot experience happiness, even if we become the Lord of the universe. Hiranyakashipu, he was the Lord of the whole material, whole universe. Even after that, he was not happy. So happiness does not come from achievements. Happiness comes from experience. And how we can experience happiness? When our mind is free from the cancer. So how we can free ourselves from these cancers? When we hear Krishna Katha. when we hear about the glories of the Supreme Lord from a bona fide source, then slowly, slowly, the cancer of the mind is cured. And when cancer of the mind will be cured, what will happen? We will also experience the happiness. And from passion, we develop compassion. Because Krishna, by this pastime, is showing how compassionate, how merciful he is. She came to kill him. And what she became? It is explained. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is always situated within the core of the heart of pure devotee. And he is always offered prayer by such worshipable personalities as Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. Because Krishna embraced Putana's body with great pleasure and sucked her breast, although she was a great witch, she attained the position of a mother in the transcendental world and thus achieved the highest perfection. What then is to be said of the cows whose nipples Krishna sucked with great pleasure and who offered their milk very jubilantly with affection, exactly like that of a mother? So Putana did not come to offer the breast milk to Krishna. She came to kill Krishna. But Krishna took the good side. Krishna thought that I sucked the breast milk from Putana. So then Putana should be regarded as my mother because the child takes milk from the breast of the mother only. So Krishna took that part only. And that shows the compassion, the mercy of Krishna. So when Sukadev Goswami was in the forest, if you are familiar with Srimad Bhagavatam, that the Putana's pastime is so significant in the life of a devotee. Sukadev Goswami was a liberated person from the womb of his mother. After coming out from the womb, he left the house immediately. And he went to the forest. He was totally liberated. He had no attraction for anything of this world. But Vyasadeva wanted to teach him Srimad Bhagavatam because he wanted to see him as a pure devotee of the Lord. So he sent his disciple, and that disciple chanted two verses from Srimad Bhagavatam. One verse talked about the beauty of Krishna, and other verse talked about the pastime of Putana. By that, he explained how merciful Krishna is. That Putana, who came to kill Krishna, but instead of punishing him, Krishna, what did he do? He gave her the position of a mother in the spiritual world, like Mother Yashoda. So how merciful Krishna is. Then who should be our master other than Krishna? Then Krishna should be the only master in our life. Because he is so merciful, he is so compassionate, he is so magnanimous. In this world, if you do 99 things good, but if you do one thing bad, people take that only. But Krishna, if you do 99 things bad, but if you do one thing good, Krishna only takes that and he rewards us the way he rewarded Putana. He rewarded her the position of a mother in the spiritual world. So what a merciful personality Krishna is. And that is his nature. That is his eternal nature. And in that way, Krishna functions. Then Putana, you have to know that Putana in her last life, previous life, there's always a connection. Nothing happens in isolation. So Boli Maharaj, you know the pastimes of Boli Maharaj and Bamandev. Boli Maharaj was the king of the demons, and Bamandev came and took all the property of Boli Maharaj. So when Bamandev came to the sacrificial arena of Boli Maharaj, so Boli Maharaj's sister, in some Puranas it says Boli Maharaj's sister, in some places it says Boli Maharaj's daughter. Some places it is said that her name was Ratnamala, in some places it is said Ratnabali, whatever. So when she saw Bamanadev, because Bamanadev was like a dwarf, is like a small child, she felt, oh, what a beautiful boy. So if I could have got a son like this, I would be so happy. So she developed the desire to become mother of Bhamanadev. Bhamanadev was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that lady, the Bully Maharaj's daughter or sister, whatever, Ratnamala, she developed the desire to become the mother of the Lord. So Lord fulfilled that desire. Then when Bhamanadev, he tricked Bully Maharaj and took away all the property of Bully Maharaj, then that same lady thought, what a dangerous boy is this? He should be killed. She developed a desire to kill that boy. So Krishna fulfilled that desire also. So in order to fulfill both the desires of that lady in her previous life, she took birth as Putana. And Putana fulfilled her desire in her past life, whatever desire she had. So she went to kill Krishna because she developed a desire to kill Vamanadev. Krishna fulfilled that desire. And she also wanted to become his mother. So Krishna fulfilled that desire also. What was the process of killing? By feeding the breast milk. And Krishna took that good side and killed Putana to protect the Brajavasis, protect all the children of the world. He did that duty, but at the same time, he rewarded her and fulfilled the desire of her to become mother. And she became the mother in the spiritual world, being the assistant to Mother Jasoda in Goloka Vrindavan. So that is the way Krishna functions. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, is the bestower of many benedictions, including liberation or oneness with Brahman effulgence. For that personality of Godhead, the gopis always felt maternal love and Krishna sucked their breast with full satisfaction. Therefore, because of the relationship as mother and son, although the gopis are engaged in various family activities, one should never think that they return to this material world after loving, after leaving their bodies. So these gopis of Vrindavan, they are eternal gopis of the spiritual world. We should not treat them as ordinary ladies of this world. So upon smelling the fragrance of the smoke emanating from Putana's burning body, many inhabitants of Brajabhumi in distant places were astonished. Where is this fragrance coming from? They asked, and thus they went to the spot where Putana's body was being burned. When the inhabitants of Braj, who had come from distant places, heard the whole story of how Putana had come and then been killed by Krishna, they were certainly astonished, and they offered their blessings to the child for his wonderful deed of killing Putana. Nanda Maharaj, of course, was very much obliged to Vasudev, who had foreseen the incident, and simply thanked him, thinking how wonderful Vasudev was. Then Sukadev Goswami is concluding by two verses, last two verses. Oh Maharaj Parikshit, best of the Kurus, Nanda Maharaj is very liberal and simple. He immediately took his son on his lap as if Krishna had returned from death, and by formally smelling his son's head, Nanda Maharaj undoubtedly enjoyed transcendental bliss. And Phalastuti, any person who hears with faith and devotion about how Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, killed Putana, and who thus invests his hearing in such childhood pastimes of Krishna, certainly attains attachment for Govinda, the Supreme Original Person. So this is the blessings Sukadev Goswami is offering. Whoever will hear with full faith and devotion will attain love for Krishna. And that is the purpose of Krishna's pastime into this world, in order to attract the conditioned soul to the spiritual world. And when a living entity somehow or other gets attracted to the activities, to the leelas, the pastimes of Krishna, then he becomes the eligible candidate to enter into the spiritual world. And that is the perfection of all life. That's why Krishna has said, Janma karma cha me divyam एवं जवत्ति तत्त त्यक्त देहम पुनर्जन्म नैति मामिति सर्जन. सो एनीबडी हु कैन अंडरस्टैंड द ट्रांसेंडेंटल अपीयरेंस एंड एक्टिविटीज ऑफ कृष्णा व्हाट हैपेंस टू हिम अपॉन लिविंग हिज बॉडी ही डज नॉट हैव टू कम बैक अगेन ही गोज बैक टू द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड इफ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द बर्थ ऑफ कृष्णा इफ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द अपीयरेंस ऑफ कृष्णा देन व्हाट विल हैपन वी डोंट हैव टू टेक बर्थ इफ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ कृष्णा If we can understand the pastimes of Krishna as transcendental, as divya, as not an ordinary activities, if we can realize that, understand that, then what will happen? We don't have to take birth again into this material world. Our cycle of birth, death, old age, and disease will be dissolved, and we'll enter into the spiritual world. And that is the purpose of human form of life, and that is the perfection of human form of life. So Krishna comes into this material world for that purpose only, to attract the conditioned soul towards him by his wonderful pastimes. And the pastimes of Krishna and Vrindavan, and especially the childhood pastimes of Krishna, is very, very attractive. And when someone develops that attraction for that activities of Krishna, for that pastimes of Krishna, his human form of life become very, very fortunate. And he gradually and steadily develops love for him. And when we develop love for Krishna, then our material existence is dissolved. Then we can enter into the spiritual world. And that will be the perfection of our life. So with that point, I like to conclude the discussion on delivering Putana by Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Do you have any question or comment? We have 10-15 minutes. Yes. So if you have any question, you can ask.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, you can hear me?
I can hear you, but if it is little louder, then it will be easier for me.
Okay, Prabhuji, I'll try to speak louder. Prabhuji, in text number 13, a comparison is made between Putta and Vritasura. And you said the comparison is with respect to the size. So my query is as follows. I wanted to understand that other than the size, is there any other point involved in this comparison?
So our acharyas are telling that Vritrasura was killed by Indra, but Vritrasura was not a demon. Vritrasura was a devotee. But Putana was a demon.
Okay, that's a good point. Yeah.
Okay.
And the second question, the last question is that in text number 14 regarding the Dhruman, that is the trees which were smashed, and if we link it to text number 34, that is the fragrance emanating from Krishna's body because Krishna had touched a Putna, so can we say that the trees which were smashed in text 14 have been delivered by Krishna because 12 miles ka trees were destroyed?
Yeah, anybody, whether plants, trees or any other living entities in Vrindavan, they are very, very special.
Yeah, so this must be an indirect connection because Krishna touched Putna and Putna touched the trees and the trees were delivered. Can we think like that? Is this correct?
Yeah, it can be, but I did not read like that, but yeah. Anybody?
I have also not read like that, but I thought about it just now.
Yeah, we can think, but we cannot say whatever has not been spoken by the acharyas. So
that is also correct. And Prabhuji, in text 33, it is written that they cut the bodies, the gopis cut the bodies and threw it far away. What is the significance of far away?
Far away means we should not burn the body in our domestic places. We should take, that's why you take the body to the bank of the river and distant places and burn the body. That is the culture.
Okay, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Yeah, Prabhuji, I have got a question.
Yes.
I need little explanation that when Putna, she came in the beginning, she was very beautiful and attractive. And when Krishna sucked her body, her breast, and you say that she became very fearful and very painful, and she started crying loudly, and her body became ugly. So how the body got transferred from beautiful to ugly? Can you please explain that?
Because the body, whatever she came with, that was the a mystical body, original body is ugly body. But if she comes with ugly body, people will suspect and will not be allowed to enter in the house of Nanda Maharaj. That's why by mystical power, she came with that beautiful body. But when Krishna killed her, that time she cannot keep that body. That mystical power vanished. So when mystical power was not working by the intervention of Krishna, then she had to come back to her original form. So you can understand that Krishna is more powerful than the mystical power of the yogis.
Yes. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
So can we say that the mystic power was purified by Krishna?
Yeah, you can say so many things, but he asked a question, I answered accordingly.
Yeah, no, I wanted to extend it. Hare Krishna.
Any other question you have? Comments?
Prabhuji, Krishna is 7 year old that time?
7 days, not 7 years.
7 days, that small boy.
Yeah, 7 days definitely small, no?
Okay.
7 years is
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Small, but 7 days is very small. You are happy with the answer?
Yes. I'm happy with the answer.
Any other question?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Can you hear me, Prabhuji?
Yes.
Prabhuji, you mentioned about transcendental sound. So, can we also put this tape of Hare Krishna Mahamantra Prabhupada chanting when we go to sleep so that it keeps running in the background?
Yeah, always. Or is it? Good. Always is good. Some transcendental sound vibration goes on. I saw some house, 24 hours, Prabhupada's thing goes on. Prabhupada said, Kirtan is Sadahari. So, if Kirtan goes on all the time, that's good. Prabhupada told that in Siddha Mayapur, the holy name should be sung 24 hours a day. So, if it's not possible by us, then at least by through his machine, some vibration is going on. It's always good. But when we chant, we should not have other sound. We should hear our own sound. That is our personal sadhana. During japa time, that should be our focus, that we should hear our chanting, not anybody else chanting. Thank other you. Time, no problem.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
Thank you. Any other question? Okay, I think. Yeah, to all of you. Hope,
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Dandavat Salam. I had a question like, even though Bhutana was a demon and she got liberated, her soul got liberated and she got the spiritual world. Why in this Kali Yuga, we take rebirth one after the another? How to get liberated? As you said, we have to do Krishna Bhakti and Hare Krishna Mahamantra chanting. So, in one birth only, it is possible to get liberated from this material body.
It's not a question of one life or a few lives like that. How many lives will be necessary depends on ourselves. So, I can tell you a small story, then I can answer your question also. So there was a man, it's a story from a village, very interesting story. So one man was staying in his village, but he did not know how far is the railway station is. And it, because he did not go to that railway station in his life, but there was some emergency and he wanted to go to the railway station to catch a train to go to some other place. So he did not know the route. So when he was going, he saw a man on the way and he asked that man, so how long it will take from here to go to the station? He was asking that question loudly again and again, but that other person, he was not responding at all. So he thought maybe he has a hearing problem or something like that. Then he started running. Then when he started running, he said, yeah, you'll need 10 minutes to go to the station. Then he said, I was asking you so loudly, so many times you did not answer. But when I started running, then you told that I need 10 minutes to go to the station. How come? He said, I did not know that which speed you'll go to the station. That's why I did not answer. When I saw you are running, then I could understand then how long it will take. So that's why I told 10 minutes. The same way, how long it will take to be liberated depends on our speed of devotional service. So you can be liberated in 7 days, just like Parikshit Maharaj got liberated in 7 days, Pattanga Maharaj liberated in one moment. And we can be liberated depending on the speed of our devotional service, intensity of our devotional service. So that intensity will come when we have intense association, intense sadhusanga. So the formula is the same. Putana got delivered because she came in touch with Krishna. In the same way, when will be in touch with Krishna, will also be delivered. And how can we be in touch with Krishna? By chanting his holy name in the association of devotees. And when we chant the holy name purely in the association of devotees, we also be liberated. We also be delivered by Krishna. Same formula works. Nothing changes. Only the details change. Principle remains the same. Okay?
Thank you, Baba.
Okay.